Okay, so let's go back to the slides. And I would like to talk about ethics and about a few other issues, because every time I talk about AI, I like to take 15 minutes, more or less, 10 minutes, 15 minutes to talk about ethical issues. So the first thing I want to talk about is a technical issue. It's not an ethical issue, it's a technical issue. It's this problem of overfitting. So let's imagine that you have a number of dots on the sheet of paper like that, and you have to approximate a line which goes through the dots as good as possible, okay? So that is one possibility. But of course, it's not very good, okay? We say that it is underfit, the error is quite large, and possibly we can try something like that. It's a simple mathematical function, but it is actually approximating the values of those dots quite well. So the error is relatively minimal. But if you let a computer get crazy, computers love to please people, okay? They are going to try to find a curve which looks like that, which goes through absolutely every point. And so in that case, the error is zero, okay? That's really cool. But if suddenly you have a point which is outside of this orange line, then the error is going to be quite large. And also processing this orange curve, this orange mathematical function, is going to be very, very time intensive. So it doesn't make sense to go into that. We say that the model is overfit, okay? And so in order to avoid overfitting of a model, there are two ways that you can do. First of all, you can do what they call regularization, which I call a Friday night. You kill 50% of your neurons, okay? Now, the cool thing is that a computer can get 50% of the neuron killed, and then after that, the next loop is going to get 50% of the neuron killed. So those neurons can be restored, which is good, right? It doesn't work the same for human brain. But basically, we say, all right, let's put the activation function to zero, and we dumb down the computer a little bit, and then we run in every iteration, in every epoch, okay? So like this, this is going to force the computer not to overperform, but to perform just well, okay? The other way that you can do is early stopping, and this is where we use the validation data that I mentioned before. What we are going to do is that we are going to try some values with training. We are going to do a number of iterations, a number of epochs, and so it looks like that. We have on the vertical axis, we have the error. On the horizontal axis, we have the number of iterations. And when we train, it's going to go like that, okay? The training is going to get better and better and better, and it's going to tend to zero. But then for every iteration, we are also going to try the validation data, and maybe it's going to look like that. There is one point where it's going to start diverging, and this is a place where you can stop the iterations because it is a place where basically it's good enough, okay? Good enough meaning that it's not too time expensive, and it does the job. It gives me predictions which are acceptable from an accuracy standpoint and from a loss standpoint. So again, those value overfitting, this is very, very often the problem with AI. It's because computers are too good at what they do, and we need to stop them when it's good enough, which is here one way using validation data. Okay, now let's talk about ethical issues, because this is probably even more important. First of all, some standard issues that you have with any technical innovation. You know, maybe AI can be used to improve weapon system, but this is really true from pretty much any system you have, okay? Anything can be used to improve weapon system. AI can be used to spy on people, and yes, this is true, it's already the case. For example, with facial recognition, with detection of suspect behavior, which of course asks the question, okay, who is suspect? Who decide what is suspect? We have privacy issues because we gather so much data. We need to make sure that this data is gathered with the user's consentment, and that the user agrees to his data being used to train AI, which is often a problem. So that can be also a big issue. And also we have deep fakes. Computers are so great at what they are doing that now you cannot trust videos anymore. I'll let you check the link later. I'll make sure that you get all the information, the slides and everything. But make sure to check this out. This is amazing. It's basically Barack Obama speaking, but actually he's not the one speaking. Somebody else is speaking. Either Barack Obama himself as a young young Obama or even an impersonator, and then they are basically faking the movements of the mouse. So what it means is that you cannot trust video anymore because computers are so powerful. If you look for deep fakes into a search engine, be careful because you will find a lot of non-suitable for work items. So be careful with that. But basically here, this is a safe example to check.